Welkom. In this movie, we will demonstrate the gap fill application in PDS. The characteristics of a side-scan sonar are known: a wide swath, but the nadir swath is blanked. We can't see any objects in the nadir swath. But what now when we use multibeam data, as multibeam data includes a nadir swath? If we simplify this in a drawing, then we have our side-scan sonar swath, we have our multibeam swath. So when we combine this, we have a full coverage. The multibeam data must be obtained simultaneously with the side-scan sonar data. When we have multibeam data, objects in the nadir are clearly visible in the multibeam data. So it is just a matter to have the multibeam data covering the side-scan sonar blanket swath with the side-scan sonar data. So this data combined will give the following side-scan sonar image. The blanket swath is covered. And now we have objects available in the original blanket swath of the side-scan sonar data, as we see here. Of course, from these objects we can also generate a target. A target in 3D from the multibeam data. And it is possible to export this to an ASCII file if we like. Gapfill is an editing process. You have to combine multibeam data with side-scan sonar data. Let's see how we do this in PDS. PDS includes a gapfill application. This must be selected. Gapfill is a processing process, so select gapfill from the processing menu. The gapfill view opens. From the import tab, the type of side-scan sonar files is selected. In this example, we select from the drop-down list the Klein SDF side-scan sonar files. The next step is to select the side-scan sonar files. Press the select button. Browse to the correct folder and select the files. Next step is to define the location for the associated multibeam files. We press the import button to start the import of the files. Dialog boxes opens when there are offsets missing. When the import was successfully, the data is displayed in the gapfill view. To display only the side-scan sonar data, we can disable the gapfill data. It is possible to change the palette color. It is possible to color the gap fill data. We see now in our gap fill data black spots. We can clearly see this in our multi-beam area editing view. So if we open this view, then we see all these spikes on the multi-beam data. As the gap fill is integrated in the PDS editing module, all editing features are available. This means we can easily add a filter to our multi-beam data to get it cleaned. A quick filter is the statistic filter. Refer to the PDS user manual for all filter settings. Most of the spikes are now removed from the multibeam data. When we press the sync view button, the gap fill view will now also use the cleaned multibeam data. The gap fill data looks now much better. And the gap fill data is ready for use. Gap fill integrated in PDS.
Teledyne RESON, everywhere you look.